You're standing on the deck of a megaship, the CMA CGM Benjamin Franklin. It's the largest container ship to ever dock in the United States. Keep an eye on that red shipping container behind you. It's about to move, and it's the size of a truck. It's one of 9,000 similarly sized containers that the Benjamin Franklin can carry in a single voyage. You're standing on the dock, where you can begin to get a sense of the ship's size. Here at the port of Long Beach, the size of the cranes limit the container stacks to 8 levels above the deck, but the Benjamin Franklin will eventually be able to handle loads up to 10 levels high. Driving the length of the ship can take several minutes. It's as long as 4 football fields. And here, you can see some of the giant cranes used to load cargo onto her deck. Here we see Velibor Karapan, the ship's captain, walking on the bridge.
Somebody would say I'm the god and the father and the mother of the crew and of everybody on board. There's 28 crew members. There are a few fellows from Croatia. There are one guy from Montenegro. Most of them are coming from Philippines. Plus we have a guy from Romania, so it's quite international crew.
Here you are now standing next to the ship's giant engine as some of her crew walks past. In all, there are 26 different nationalities on board.
The backgrounds are different, mentalities, cultures are different and everything. But our goal, our mission, let's say, is the same. Our souls in some way are the same because we are all the seamen, so we understand each other.
We're standing now on the crow's nest, and believe it or not, we're still on board the Benjamin Franklin at one of the highest points of the ship. All of those containers you're looking at are above her deck, and there's many more below as well. From here, you can see just how wide the ship is, wider in fact than a 12-lane highway. The images you're seeing are sped up to twice the speed of reality, so you can see how the cranes unload the vessel. Here's Captain Karapan, looking over the navigational charts. He says regardless of the ship's size, she can still be affected by Mother Nature.
Any storm can be a real challenge. The winter storms like there you have them now in the North Pacific. Despite the size of the vessel, you always must be very, very careful, you know. Don't take granted the size of the vessel, yeah, that is going to protect you. You always respect the sea.
Keeping him cautious are memories he has from an experience earlier in his career when a ship he served on was caught in massive waves.
Yeah, there's a huge storm in northern Atlantic at the time, and the height of the waves and the length was beyond any imagination, you know. So actually the wind force was nobody could measure, so maybe even 70, 80, or 100 miles, you know, you can guess it in that moment, yeah, you know. Only later on I realized what we went through. So, and this really was a huge experience. Nobody can share such experience with you. You have to survive it. You have to live it through.
Here we get a wider perspective of the ship's single engine, which can take it across the Pacific in just 2 weeks. And finally, here we are with the containers once again, and we can see how deep they go below the deck. What's inside is anyone's guess. A lot of the goods that come into the US from Asia include textiles, food, and technology. But the captain says he doesn't think about the financial value when he's at sea.
There are, I suppose, hundreds of millions of dollars, so the value of the cargo plus the ship and everything, but on the very first place, and this is something you have, anybody, you know, who is in command, he must have, it's a human beings. So it's a human life on the very first place. Don't think about the financial responsibilities. It's beyond your, you know, what you can do. Or so first you have, if you are trying and you're doing everything to keep, to save the human lives, yes, of course you're going to save the cargo and the ship itself.